Welcome to Daily News Update. I'm Petty Officer Kat Smith, and these are your headlines from around the fleet. The Navy commissioned USS George H.W. Bush January 10th in Norfolk, honoring the former president. President Bush spoke about the significance of this ship to the Navy and the country.
The ship is a fitting tribute to a generation of men with whom my dad was privileged to serve. She's also a tribute to a new generation of American soldiers and sailors and Coast Guard men and women, airmen and Marines, who have stepped forward to defend the United States of America.
Secretary of the Navy Donald Winter attended the ceremony and talked about why this commissioning was special to him.
Of all the commissioning ceremonies that I've had the honor to participate in, today's ceremony stands out above them all. Nothing else compares to the arrival of a new nuclear-powered carrier in our fleet. The impact of a new carrier is global, for no other ship represents to the world the power of the United States the way this does.
The George H.W. Bush is the 10th and final Nimitz-class aircraft carrier. CVN 78, named after former President Gerald Ford, will begin the new Ford-class carriers. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day is January 19, 2009. This year's theme is Remember, Celebrate, Act, a day on, not a day off. Commands are encouraged to learn about Dr. King's legacy and support community events. For more information, read NAVADMIN 003/09. From the Defense Media Activity Anacostia, I'm Petty Officer Kat Smith.